do a transit trial with the 3884. The building's still there on the last street there. And we had a water main break, 1839, due to frost. We began testing our water in 1896. And just contextually, the first flight was in 1903 in North Carolina, nothing to do with Toronto. We had a great fire in 1904, which destroyed the downtown portion of Toronto. Over $10 million of damage at that time, but nobody died. Now you see Old City Hall, you see it at the top of the street, there's Bay Street, right? 5,000 people out of work. A few years later, the Nielsen Building on King Street collapsed. So we began putting chlorine in the water in 1910. Some of those conduits, some of those pipes are still in place. We had our first plane crash in 1911. And think about this. So 34 ships, 270 sailors died on Lake Ontario in a storm. Right? Because there was a lot of marine transport back then. 270 people. 1914, the Canadian Red Cross set up in Toronto. Ferry accident on the Scarborough Bluffs in 1915. And another cholera epidemic. That's the Don River. So the Don River frequently floods. And it floods more so now because we've extended the land surface beyond the mouth of the Don where it should be. And then the stock market crash in 1929. Eastern Avenue Bridge collapsed in 1929 over the Don River.
And they put the bridge back, didn't they?
It's still there, but it's not used. Coldest day on record, minus 45, and the lake actually froze over.
Oh.
Entire lake. The heat wave, look at those scandalous outfits. The heat wave, 44 degrees. 1,200 people died in 1936. Of the heat wave. Right? Stuff that we can't really understand. Pearson International Airport, 1938, and now renamed. This is in Canada, of course, but 1939, the war broke out. Canada joined the effort. Our most snow, 48 centimeters in 1944. How many of you remember when Mel Lastman brought in the army?
Mm-hmm.
We had 18 centimeters that day. 139 people died of fire and boat at the foot of the bay. This is Hurricane Hazel, 1954. That whole neighborhood got wiped out in the Humber River. 36 people died. And that's why we don't build riverines and valleys anymore. Five firefighters died trying to help out on the scene, which led to the Toronto Regional Conservation Authority, which we take measures to prevent this from happening again. My office formed in 1960. Just contextually, the Americans landed on the moon, or did they?
Supposedly.
Yeah. Supposedly. Supposedly. Or did they? Now, I don't remember this, but in 1970, 100 people died in an airplane accident at Pearson International. So the St. Lawrence Seaway Distribution Center opened in 1970. Pickering opened in 1973. CN Tower in 1975. Mississauga Train Derailment in 1979. 250,000 people were evacuated. The entire city of Mississauga. Nobody injured. And then we had that sunrise propane explosion a couple years ago. Now the worst terrorist event in Canadian history was the Air India flight. One person was arrested, 320 people died. The person served less than 5 years. Figure that one out. Yes. The internet in 1990. Do people remember 7 chemical port in Scarborough that caught fire in 2000. The World Trade Center, 24 Canadians did die. All the airplanes were grounded across North America. I was there with my daughter 3 weeks before. I mean, one of the neatest pictures I had. Just on top of the World Trade Center. We had SARS epidemic, then the blackout in 2003. 10 million people without power. Remember the Air France crash? Nobody died. All 300 people got out. But now with climate change, we have severe floods in localized areas that we can't predict or can't prevent. That one, because of maintenance issues, Finch Avenue collapsed over a bridge. Hurricane Katrina was a major event in North America, we all remember. I think it's six right here, so I'll just have to personally advance it. Now look at the devastation, those are all rooftops. So certainly want to prevent that from happening again. Propane sunrise explosion, 2008. 12,000 people were evacuated. The poor fella doing the transfer got killed. The G20 summit. You all remember that? Elliott Lake Mall collapse. Those were Canadian, Toronto personnel with the Hussar heavy urban search and rescue. And then we've had many severe floods. That's the Don Valley Parkway with cars submerged. Earthquakes, that's Nepal, certainly not here. 1,800 people killed. Ontario is a very active earthquake zone, mind you. So there just seem to be moderate so far.
And there's a fault line running right under the ocean here.
Many fault lines. I live close to the lake, so I'm hoping for lakefront property. Right? So, you know. And then, you know, we have the severe weather-related events. We all remember the Philippines and 40 million people died. 2008, 140,000 people died. And then Fort McMurray last year, where 80,000 people were evacuated with no deaths. 2,400 buildings were destroyed. And like I said, close to 9,000 people evacuated. And you have severe cyclones and storms, that's a shark, like a mile away from the ocean. And then we had a quick ice storm. How many of you personally were disrupted in the ice storm? Right? We'll talk about that. And lately we've had a major political event. So the tragic soldier was tragically killed on Remembrance Day a few years ago. And recently, in the beginning of this year, we had that horrible attack at the mosque in Quebec, Montreal. And then St. Lawrence flooding, Lake Ontario rising, 130 communities affected, 700 people forced to leave. And who can say what tomorrow will bring?
Sure.
So that's why I'm here, and that's why you're here, okay? So, does anybody think another major event is not going to happen?